I might need to clean house, but first, I want you to give me a full report. They seem nice enough to me, but apparently there have been some issues.
Like what?
Well, I'll let you see that for yourself, but then I'm gonna need that full report, okay?
Okay, Bob.
Oh, and while you're here, perhaps just call me Mr. Lancaster.
All right.
Everyone, hi. I'd like to introduce you to our new intern, Calvin. Calvin's gonna be with us for the next little while, and I want you to treat him like a member of the family. Calvin? Meet the gang. Megan, in charge of bins. Mick, in charge of scanner.
Sir?
Yes?
It's Mick.
Right. Mikey, in charge of detector. And Ella and Ian, in charge of bags.
I am so glad you're joining our team. I'm sure you'll be a great fit. We have a really great group of people here. If you have any questions, don't be shy. We will answer any of your questions. And remember, there aren't any stupid questions.
Well, thank you, Ella. Well, that sure was a warm welcome. I am glad that everyone's getting along.
Why wouldn't we be getting along? Jerk.
What was that, Ella?
Nothing, you old goat.
Right, well, I better get going, because this airport isn't going to run itself. Right, well, good luck.
Thanks, Mr. Lancaster.
You seem pretty chummy with the big boss.
Yeah, I've never seen Mr. Lancaster even acknowledge an intern.
I'm surprised he remembered our names.
Oh, I like Mr. Lancaster. He's a kind man.
I think he's great. I like Bob. Mr. Lancaster.
He looks like a Bob.
What does a Bob look like? A tyrant? He's a tyrant!
I don't know. He looks like him. He's very Bob-esque, you know? He couldn't be... He couldn't be a Jerry or an Andrew, he's a Bob.
You know, in my entire life, I don't think I've ever met a Jacob or a Reese that I liked. A Ryan, mind you.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I'm naturally drawn to people named Liam.
Come stand by us.
Does he have to?
Be nice. This should be hilarious.
Just watch.
Hi, ladies. You're looking well.
Thanks, Mikey.
So, Lauren, are you working a double shift today?
Unfortunately.
I know, right? These double shifts are killers. They don't leave much time for a social life.
Yeah, just like my mom. She's a teacher. No life. Anyway, gotta open up shop.
Sure thing.
Emma, why don't you ever respond to any of my texts?
I've been really busy.
Well, consider this your first warning, because, baby, offers like this don't come around every day.
Please don't call me baby.
Ian, don't you think you're coming on just a bit too strong?
Nick, the way I see it here, there are two options. One, I could be like our friend Mikey.
Hey! Just waiting for the right moment. These things take time.
Moment shmoment. You stumble over your own words and you're unable to ask the girl out. Pathetic!
I'm not pathetic. I'm in love.
Okay, and what's the second way that you could be like?
Like me.
A great A.
We are here, ladies and gents, ready to cook for you.
A
Come on in, ladies. She cute, but she ain't making me lunch.
Why not?
It's a disgusting establishment.
She cute, but she gross. I hope you brought your own lunch.
I didn't. Are there any other restaurants?
The new guy forgot his lunch.
Don't worry, it's not that bad.
You just said it's a disgusting establishment.
Oh yeah. It's shockingly terrible. Truly ghastly.
Nick, you know the drill.
Yeah, yeah.
You guys are ridiculous.
What's going on?
Watch.
All right, ladies. This red bag needs to be checked. Ladies! We're just gonna take a look to see what you have. So, where are your girls off to? Your boyfriends must be upset that you weren't with them.
We're going to LA to meet a manager.
You guys are models? Man, your boyfriends must be jelly as helly.
We're musicians, we don't have boyfriends.
Oh, it's a shame about the boyfriends, really. So, when are you coming back to Montreal? Maybe we can have a coffee and you can tell me all about your trip.
Makeup, a book, you can go.
Thanks.
Well, if you change your mind, I'm here. I'd love to hear that sweet voice sing.
I think she liked you.
Ella, there is no way that either of those girls liked him. Now, can we stop trying to find Ian a girlfriend and focus on security? Am I the only one who takes my job seriously?
That's a hard yes, but to be fair, I don't know anyone who takes anything so seriously. My friends are just—
Asinine, idiotic, unintelligent, simple-minded, obtuse.
There's nothing obtuse about them. They don't live to work, they work to live. They're just simple people, easily satisfied.
I did say simple-minded. Ma'am, bag and passport, please. Ma'am?
No picture, no picture.
Ma'am, I don't want your picture. I just want you to put your bag down.
Please, I don't sign autographs.
I bloody believe you.
Ian, yay or nay?
Nay. Too high maintenance.
I don't blame you.
No picture, no picture. I deserve privacy just like anybody.
Ma'am, this is an airport. Security isn't really our top priority.
Who is this chick?
I think she's dating a Montreal Canadian. Some people say that Terrien did what was best for the team.
Listen, new kid! We don't say the T word around here.
Team?
No! The other one.
Terrien?
What did I just say? We're all still healing.
It's best not to talk about hockey in general while working in Montreal. I mean, I hate hockey, but they don't know. Mikey is as passionate about the Habs as he is about Lauren.
True. Where the hell have you been?
Not big shot, not big shot.
Stop, I have the flash. No picture, no picture.
Ma'am, bag, passport,
sunglasses.
She looks so familiar.
Oh, she dated PK. I love the Habs.
But you just...
Just ignore her.
But that name doesn't sound familiar. Isabella, Anna Maria, blah, blah, blah.
According to her passport, she's Isabelle Chartrand.
Isabelle Chartrand, that's it. She's dated a few Habs players since she was on that show Hockey Wives. But on a serious note, guys, what am I gonna do with Lauren?
Wish her well and move on? Get used to being in the friend zone?
Just ask her out.
I'm with Ella. Ask her out.
But maybe give up.
What?
Don't listen to her.
It's just that I look at her and I see my future. I get lost in her eyes.
Well, get a roadmap and find your way to reality. We've got work to do.
A little harsh.
You know what's harsh? Not taking national security seriously. Man bag and passport?
Here you are.
Everything okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
It's difficult to travel alone.
Tell me about it.
All right, well, have a nice day.
Not likely.
Thanks for nothing, Nick!
What?
You just let my future wife walk by, and I didn't get to go through her bags or ask her out!
Dude, she's clearly upset.
I know! The timing was perfect!
You're such a pig!
Seriously, Ian. Have some consideration for other people's feelings.
But maybe he's a genius. Like Will Ferrell in Wedding Crashers.
What?
He goes to funerals to pick up girls.
Ella, no offense, but you might be more demented than Ian.
I understand that you all are having fun referencing pop culture. We've got a job to do.
Megan, you need to relax. Go on a date. Find a boyfriend.
I have a boyfriend. Actually, I have a fiance.
Oh, poor guy. How did that happen? Did you propose?
Have I told you, you are the most beautiful wife?
Not in the last 5 minutes, husband.
Well, you are.
I love you, Evan Bear.
Oh, I love you, Carly Bear. We're going on our honeymoon.
It's an amazing place. Some might even call it paradise.
Oh, I think they're just delightful. Marriage is so sacred.
Guys, we only met 9 months ago, but it was crazy. We were both on vacation, and he came up to me, and he said, "Do you remember what you said?"
Oh, I'll never forget.
He said, "You are the most beautiful girl I have ever seen." We watched the sunset and spoke for 8 hours straight. My poor French just waited around while I met the love of my life. How nice. Passport.
Then, a few months later, he gave me this ring.
What?
50% of marriages end in divorce. It's an antiquated tradition, if you ask me.
You just said marriage is sacred.
I told you to ignore her.
No one asked you. And you know what? What they have, that special crazy bond, that's all I want. Where are you off to today? Are you traveling alone? We're just gonna have to bring your bag to the counter. It's just a routine check.
Cat got your tongue?
Yeah.
From Montreal? Going to see your boyfriend? Wanna go out sometime? Sweet!
You're good to go.
Julio, my man!
Yeah, looking good. How's it going with the ladies?
I just met one that didn't reject me directly, so I'm feeling pretty good.
That's amazing, man. How about you go and get her and I'll replace you?
Thanks, man, you're the best.
Do not hit on Lauren.
No promises.
So, Julio, how's Angus?
Tired. The job isn't easy. It takes a lot out of you, you know?
Yeah, he looked pretty tired yesterday.
Yeah, but he loves what he does, so I guess that makes it worth it, right?
Exactly. You need to love what you do. We should all be doing what we are paid to do, am I right? Passports and bags?
I think we know the drill.
Who does she think she's talking to?
I know, right?
Does she even fly, though?
Where are you off to today?
I'm a pilot. I'm headed to
Paris. He's going to Paris with me.
Oh, had no idea you were flying a plane. Watch it. You know what happens when you play with fire?
I do. Because I'm a pilot.
Playing with fire will cause you to exit there, or there, or there.
I'm a pilot. You know, I fly planes like you.
Dude, no way!
You're just jealous because, well, they check our bags, we get to bring ours all around the world.
Aren't you still on domestic flights?
Nobody asked you, Julio.
Why is that necessary? Vancouver's fun and cool. Do you have to be so mean?
Never said there was anything wrong with domestic flights.
Like, I have to be the one to console her now.
On my account, I get a discount. So listen, since you didn't, you know, completely reject me back there, I was wondering, maybe I can take you out sometime, somewhere nice, somewhere romantic, but affordable. What do you say?
You're on your own.
Okay, well. Here's my number. Call me, okay?
Can I be real with you?
What?
You just lost $24.99.
What about my employee discount?
Oops. You need to stop buying every pretty girl travel supplies. They literally fly away with them.
Ian!
A word. What?
What did I tell you about talking to Lauren?
I don't remember.
I told you not to. Anyway, your break is over. Go take my place. Hey, Lauren. So, how's your bacon? How's your day been?
Well, it's still morning, and it's not really busy, so I guess it's okay.
Cool.
So lame. Can I take my break now?
Sure.
I was thinking we should hang
out. Sorry, do you have any more tissues?
Of course, they're right here, on the house.
Thank you.
Ian says he needs you desperately. He can't live without you, and it's not your turn to take break.
Think about it, okay?
Think about what?
No, sir, while that curse is talking to her and she doesn't know.
Get out of my spot!
Do you give a lot of things away for free?
I pay for things like that. You never know what people are going through.
But you apply your discount.
What's it to you, new guy?
Just wondering.
So, you're the new guy?
Yep.
I'm Margaret, and that's Celine and Erica.
I'm Calvin. Shouldn't you be wearing gloves?
So I can poison people with the chemicals on the gloves. No thanks. What did I tell you? You need to drink more water. You should be carrying around a 2-liter jug with you at all times.
I told you, I just have a little cough.
It sounds like a big cough. You should probably go home.
No offense to that, but I'll go home when I'm ready.
So, what do you want to eat?
I had a big breakfast.
Okay, so just a coffee on the house?
You guys sure do love giving things away on the house.
Sure do. Don't worry about her coughing all over it. It helps your immune system. Soon you'll be strong like bull.
Thanks.
Ma'am, that new password, you have your electronics?
I have a bag of liquids, and here's my phone, laptop, tablet, and this is a book where I write down all memories. For instance, this morning I wrote down the following. Today, I'm afraid to fly. I know that flying is safer than being in a car, but I'm afraid. I'm afraid. Last night I had a dream. I was on a plane and there was turbulence. What if I get stuck in the bathroom and there's turbulence?
Get a bunch of blue water in your clothing.
Nick! Ma'am, it's okay that you're afraid to fly. I'm assuming it's your first time flying.
Yes, it is.
Just remain calm. And should you have any worries, ask a flight attendant to help. That's what they're there for.
I just...
You'll be fine. What?
That you're a people person?
Yes, my fiance.
Poor guy.
What did you say?
Poor pie.
That's what we need more of.
Pie.
Nice save. Vegas! 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 Vegas!
With a bit of enthusiasm.
love with you. But I hate your friends! I'm so glad you're finally taking a break from work. But secretly, I wish you had taken it with me!
I don't know what to say. That's a lot to process.
Good. I'll miss you.
Okay.
He could be the one. I just have to keep it cool.
Right.
Okay, now, Dougie, you'll call me when you get there.
Yes, dear.
And you won't stay up too late.
Yes, dear.
And you'll stay away from lactose. Remember what happened at Jack Astor's? You had to stay put, and I had to run all the way to Winners to get your new pen.
Megan!
Just reminding you so that you don't embarrass yourself again.
Hey, I enjoyed every single bit of that artichoke dip, and I'd do it again! If they still had it on the menu.
Don't worry, Megan. I'll take care of him.
I don't believe that for one second.
It's not that you can't bring these items. It's just that, well, they're very peculiar.
Well, this is for my anxiety.
And the pills?
They're lactose pills.
For your friend?
Yeah, they're filled with lactose. Who knows when you'll need them?
Won't that make him...
Yeah, it'll make him... But it's his bachelor party.
Okay, but then, well, what is this for?
That is nothing. Put it back. Let's go, Dougie. Vegas.
Okay, don't worry.
I still can't believe you have a fiancé.
I told you.
I also can't believe Ella's the one that set you up and now you're getting married.
Yeah, but I don't believe in marriage. But I'm so happy for you two. Thanks.
Man password in bag?
Yep, no problem.
Absolutely.
Nothing!
Good. No name calling or physical harm.
That's great.
This should be fun. We don't always get to see our family.
And don't worry, Dad. I won't tell us if you see that. I didn't know Jack was blocked.
Boss, don't block you, dummy.
Shoes and walk through again.
I can't remove my shoes.
Ma'am, please remove your shoes.
I can't.
Why not?
I just can't, okay?
Can I just pass?
Sir, can you please wait your turn?
Please don't make me take off my shoes.
You're not going to make your flight.
Fine. But can I pass through first before my shoes go through your scanner?
Can I go through?
Sir, please. And yes, just go through.
Shoes are okay, right?
Yeah.
No crazy forces at work today?
No.
Perfect.
Can I go now?
Just wait until her shoes are on.
Can I go now?
Sec! Yep. Nick, you good?
Yep.
Okay, sir, go ahead.
Finally.
Sir, we're going to have to look through your bags and your person.
This is absolutely ridiculous. Do you even know who I am? It's not like I'm a businessman. My name is Mr. J.J. Ryerson Hingbun, man of business off to Toronto. I'm not-
Sir, please wait here while we call logistics.
You've got to be kidding me. Are you serious?
Julio's on his way.
Unbelievable. Unfreaking believable.
Sir, can you please calm down?
I will not calm down. First, I have to deal with the snowbirds, then the freak who won't take her shoes off, and now this? No, I will not calm down.
Make sure you hand both back to Julio.
Sir, follow me. Sir? Please don't make this more difficult than it has to be.
Unhand me!
Sir, please cooperate. This doesn't have to be a major issue.
I am humiliated.
Ma'am, you're gonna have to remove your mask. Moreover, you're gonna have to hand me your passport.
Can you please wear gloves?
Excuse me?
Please don't handle my items without gloves.
Ma'am, my hands are clean.
How often do you clean these bins?
Just walk through.
It's okay. It's okay. She has clean hands. She has clean hands.
Finally, a lull. Can't stand it when things slow down.
Work or your social life, because from what I can see, your social life isn't so fast-paced either.
Ha ha, very funny.
You gotta admit, it was kinda funny.
And, how's Lauren? Hey, Mikey?
How you gonna do me like that, man?
Guys, who does this bag belong to?
Shoot.
Crap. Get logistics on the line. Tell them to call Julio and Angus.
Should've kept my mouth shut when I saw two.